and particularly with respect not only to India, coming to Kerala, we are facing lot of several issues with reference to the agriculture sector. Our agriculture GSDP contribution has been falling down. There has been large scale conversion of agricultural land in non-agricultural purposes, indiscriminate use of chemical fertilizers, lot of public health issues, and recently we had a very severe flood, completely collapsing our environmental, ecological and social systems. And in this context, looking to the way forward, we need policies with a holistic approach which focus on sustainable agricultural practices. And in terms of, here comes the role of system thinking approach to address the diverse issues of Kerala agriculture. And we need a change in the policy arena which demands a change in the academic discourse. And in this context, we had collaborative efforts with Norwegian University of Life Sciences for the last 2 years, and we were running a certificate course in agroecology, action learning and research. And more specifically, we would like to model our course as an education prototype which can be included in the educational landscape of our society. And this course is a maiden step towards participatory learning in Kerala, having interdisciplinary nature and system thinking approach. And this is the whole summary of the course that we were having for the last 2 years, and we plan to conduct during the course of the next one. 28 days, 9 participants, 1 course facilitators, and there were 3 interactive sessions with the experts, were 3, and we chose companies representing both traditional and modern agricultural practices, and the students produced these documents, learner documents, case study reports, client documents, and reflective journals. And we had practiced several competencies. This is the whole structure of the course, and these competencies were practiced, and this is the major thrust of the course. And coming to the reflection that we had on the course that we had for the last 2 years, and motto of Kerala University is Karmani Vyajane Prajna, that is Sanskrit, wisdom manifests itself in action. But wisdom has to come from concrete experience, reflective observation, abstract conceptualization, and generally active experimentation. And what we follow in our state, the course structure focuses on providing degree in learning based on theory. Teachers carry on with monologues, courses lacks a transdisciplinary approach, and what we have, what we practice there is that we consider purpose of education as merely pursuing a degree and accumulating theoretical knowledge. And it is in this context that action-based learning becomes very important, and the course tries to inculcate 3 levels of learning, individually, in group and in class as a whole, and the multi-perspective, multidisciplinary, transdisciplinary approach which will strengthen understanding of complex issues and deepen the learning experience. And the divergent knowledge in this case gets transformed to assimilative knowledge and then to convergent knowledge. And for the last 2 years, I feel that my goal has been changed from a teacher to a facilitator, and a holistic action-based model in everything, the 5 competencies in these stages, a shift from the conceptual model of learning. And what we have seen is that there has been a very important shift in the understanding of the students, and my students and me realized that it's high time to go out of the traditional conventional classroom and apply those ideas in the society and be agents of change. And definitely there has been a lot of hindering forces that we face, because even the mindset that we have as teachers and students in our university is very different from what we need for an action learning model. And at all levels, right from the student level, there are hurdles to implement these policies. But anyhow, there are several supporting forces which we would like to capitalize on, and because of the hard work, the successful running of the course, and we have been granted with the Center for Agroecology and Public Health, so that we are now free to run these courses on our own. And regarding the 2 questions, I would like to put those answers together for those questions. After 4 years, we wish to have more collaboration with, this is what we lack in our university, with society, collaboration with NGOs, government institutions, local self-governments, which will culminate in the improvement of social capital, which empowers all stakeholders in co-creation and co-evaluation of knowledge. And then we would like to model our course as an educational prototype to bring change in farming and food systems, and would like to implant or implement it in the educational policy arena of our state. And definitely we envision that this course will improve the competency for creation for all the stakeholders involved, also envisage for the creation of operational groups, including teachers, students, scientists, farmers, and local self-governments to reduce the distance between academia and the society, and to create a green community with system thinking and holistic approach. Because what we feel is that development of human resources is what is needed first in order to make a green shift, and the formation of a generic curricula, which is the main objective of the next one, both the green and soft skills, and a right blending of theory and action, and that has to be experimented in the learning loops and cycles that we plan and implement, and then reflect and vision, and maybe by the end of 4 years, we feel that we can have a group of green and soft skills with proper blending theory and action, and addressing local needs along with the the broad NextFood objective. And the intervention levels and the micro level, after 4 years, we would like to create agents of change by popularizing action-based learning, and these agents definitely can be students from heterogeneous educational backgrounds and their networks, and the mentors and facilitators of the course who have both the qualitative and quantitative skill, and we can record and analyze and analyze the transformation that is happening to the students. And again, the farmers can also be the agents of change, where they are involved in the participatory learning and act as a link between academia and society, and along with the students will be the basic unit of experimentation to achieve the objective of sustainable agricultural and farming systems. At the meso level, collaborating with
you can spend another minute.
So with the stakeholders, LSTs, governmental departments, and a model agroecological farm owned by the community, and to identify local knowledge and to bring it into economic discourse, and it's the last one. At the macro level, becoming a part of the transformation happening all over the world through sustainable policies at the national and international level, contributing to the generation of the creation of generic curricula so that this can be replicated, and finally popularizing action-based learning and research. Thank you.